So welcome to our third video in our Thriving Through Conflict series. I think you're really going to enjoy this one. I learned a lot about compromise, times when it's good, times when it's not so good, and just the five different conflict styles and actually when they're all helpful and when they're all destructive. So what have you got for us today, Jess?
So we've got looking at the five different conflict management styles that come into play, and we're going to take a quick look through each of those now. So we have lovely little shark up in the corner competing. So this is when it's a bit of an I win, you lose. Like, I'm right, the point of the conflict is more important than the relationship. And then moving down to the little avoiding turtle is when it's a bit of a lose-lose. Like, you avoid the conflict completely. It's not worth it, what's the point, or you don't like conflict. In the middle we have the compromising fox. This is when you need a bit of a solution, you both agree to something but you might not fully be pleased with the results, a bit of win some, lose some situation. Down the bottom right hand corner we have the little accommodating teddy bear who's quite passive and will give in usually. They don't like the tension, so I'll do what you want, a bit of an I lose, you win situation. And then up in the top right hand corner we have the collaborating owl, the wise owl. This is the best style of managing conflict, which is a bit of a win-win approach. The relationship's important and everyone's needs are met as best as possible.
I think that's really powerful when you're talking about compromise being not always being a great solution, because I think for me, I'll just put myself out there, like, I often think compromise is like when you're doing really well in conflict, but looking at that, those images, I'm like, okay, that actually collaborating is better if we can make that work. Than actually compromising, which always sounds like you're doing the right thing.
Yeah, and compromise. It's not that it's necessarily wrong, but sometimes, and maybe not in all, but sometimes it is a better solution if we actually think through, okay, we've got a compromise, but are there other alternatives that would make it even more of a win-win for both of us?
Yeah.
So we've got a hopefully fun little example of how this might play out. Okay, so we've got a bit of a dilemma here. The scenario is that Ben wants to make a glass of orange juice that requires one orange. I want to make an orange cake which requires the zest of one full orange. There's only one orange left though. So we're going to go through each of the styles of conflict to show how they might play out. So you kindly put the orange back, Ben. We can start. So this is a bit of the competing option. So no, I want it. Just give it to me.
I need the whole orange for myself.
No, I want it. I'm taking it. I'm right.
To get a whole glass of orange juice, I need a whole orange.
You get the idea. We're competing. We both want it. No winning there. Okay, so the second style is accommodating. So, all right. Hey, Ben, I need the orange for my cake.
But I really need the whole orange for my whole glass of orange juice.
You take it then, it's fine.
Thank you.
All right, avoiding. So go for it, Ben. Hey, Ben, I need that for the cake. So the next one is compromising. I need one orange for the cake.
I need a whole orange for my glass of orange juice.
Do you want to cut it in half?
Yeah, half, that's fair. Yeah, you get half, I get half, right?
You get half each. All right, half and half. Here's one we prepared earlier, Ben, there's your juice.
So, I only get a little bit of juice.
Yeah, I didn't get enough orange zest for my cake either. But we didn't argue, so it's a win, right? All right, so the final one is collaborating. So, hey Ben, I need an orange for my cake.
Well, Jess, I actually really need a whole orange for my glass of orange juice.
Well, what are we going to do?
So you need the outside of the orange.
Yeah, I do.
I need the inside of the orange.
Yeah.
What if you take all the zest off it first and then you can give it back to me and I can have my juice?
Brilliant idea.
We're good at this.
Win-win. So how was that?
I think it was really good. It was good to actually act out for me, like the different types of conflict styles.
Yeah.
I definitely did different ones at different times.
Absolutely.
I hadn't really thought through that when you compromise and neither you really win, which sounds healthy, and kind of is at times, right? There's times for it, but
Absolutely. There's
times actually where you both lose. It's like, you're like, neither of you lose big, but you both kind of lose as well.
So win some, lose some. And so the ideal in that scenario was the collaborating. We both got a whole orange out of it.
Yep.
But that's not always going to be possible. So, you know, some of these styles, and whilst, you know, we went for the fight with the competing, sometimes it's actually, there's times for it where you need to really stand up for your rights, or it's to do with morals, and it just needs to be firm.
Yeah.
Sometimes accommodating might be that, you know, the bigger picture.
Yeah.
The relationship's more important. It might be about giving that customer a refund, even though you know they really don't deserve one, or it's not right.
Yeah.
You want to keep a good customer experience.
Yeah.
Even, you know, compromising can still be the best thing to do when there's no other solutions, because it means you actually have a solution. And avoiding can sometimes be just because you're not ready to deal with that conflict yet. You still need to think about it.
Live to fight another day.
Yeah, so there's, you know, with each of these conflict management styles, there are some scenarios that actually, you know, they can be a positive in. So collaborating is like the, you know, the gold standard, I guess.
The
but
ideal.
We're not always going to get to the collaboration because it might require a compromise instead. Yeah. So, but at least we didn't fight with the compromise.
No, I was even thinking like avoiding could be picking your battles. Like
there's
a reason. Sometimes you can pick different styles of conflict depending on the outcome. It's, you know.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Can't win them all.
No. Like, so. Exactly. Yep. So I guess it comes down to, you know, what is the scenario? What's the most important thing in that scenario?
Yep.
What's the relationship that's at risk or at tension in that scenario? So thinking through. But we have left you with a little PDF down in the links in the description below if you want to read through those conflict management styles in a little bit more depth. And then next time we are introducing you to the Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse. Stay tuned.